Imagine you can upload a large PDF document and use AI to analyze all the insights you need for you. Does that sound good? I'll show you a tool that recently I'm exploring, which can do exact the same thing I mentioned. Check it out. Hi, welcome to Bear Academy. I'm Bear. Recently, I started to explore AI, especially ChatGPT, Notion AI, and Midjourney. And one of the biggest use cases that I want to use is to use AI to help me analyze some work documents. And sometimes they are PDFs or Google Sheet or other kind of documents, and help me to tidy it up or give me the summary or give me some insights from the report without hallucination. And this is quite often for using current tools, current AI tools, that you have got some assumptions or some imaginations from AI. And I don't need that. So because of that, recently I explored this tool, which called ChatDoc. And this is probably the best tool currently on the market for analyzing PDF files. And yeah, it can do what it mentioned, chat with documents, get instant answers with cited sources. So here's the website about how this product looks like and how it functions. And here, I'll just show you an example of uploading a large PDF file and use it to analyze. And as I'm working at Zero, a financial company, so I've got this financial annual report from this year, recently just published, and it's a public document, so it should be all good to use this as an example to analyze it. And if I open it, you can see this document is quite a large document with many pages, and all the pages with detailed information content from different categories. And I probably won't read it from cover to cover, so I can use it to analyze. So the first step, I'll just go to chatdoc.com and logged in with my Google account. And from here, you can see there are two types of the accounts. First is a free account and the paid account. For free account, you can upload up to 50 pages PDF files, and each file can top to 36 megabytes, which is quite large. And also you can upload two files in 24 hours and ask 50 questions. So pretty much that's quite friendly for free account. But as a paid account, which I'm currently as a paid account, it's quite powerful. Now I can update to 500 pages per PDF, and also I can even upload different files like Markdown files or Google Doc or Word Docs, other different types of the docs. And imagine you can upload all your annual reports or other things to this document. So yeah, you can see the difference, and it's quite simple. So first step, let's just upload this document and let's see how it goes. Right, now you see this document is updated, is uploaded to ChatDoc, and it's really fast, as I already uploaded this document previously. So here you can see there are already some pre-populated questions that I can check. For example, what is Xero's commitment to diversity, inclusion, and belonging, and other things. And basically I can just type question here, and then it will get me some answers. So maybe I'll just ask really simple questions like how many subscribers for that Xero got this financial year. How many subscribers Xero got this year? Right, let's see the result. Cool, it told me that Xero got 417,000 subscribers during financial year 23, bringing the total subscribers to 3.7 million at the end of last financial year, which is quite good. And you might notice that it also shows pages below this answer so that I can just check and just click it and it will go to specific page and then show me the result. For example, this one, our total global subscribers increased 40% to 3.74 million. That's great. So I will have an answer, and also it's a true answer without any hallucination. That's awesome. That's got some other questions, maybe tougher questions. Right, I got this question. I just pre-populated here. So what was the contribution that small businesses market for Xero's last financial year? Just because I'm more working at a small business part of the business, so I want to know what's the contribution, like how many revenue that it contributed. Okay, so now I got the answer. According to Xero's annual report of 2023, the company generated around 1.4 billion and ended financial year with 3.74 million. Okay. Right, and around more than 180 countries. So far, it didn't tell me exactly, but I think this number is a really starting point, a good starting point that I can take a look. So maybe I didn't get exact the numbers, the contribution for small businesses of the whole year's revenue, but still, I got some solid answers anyway. So let's get another thing. This is something I'm interested because I'm going to work on a product for sole traders, and I want to know, does this report mention anything about sole traders, especially strategy or business goals or anything? Right, so I just start to ask this question and let's see. Right, it said there's no direct mention of the sole traders in Xero annual report. However, it report emphasizes their commitment to make life better for small businesses worldwide, which could potentially include sole traders. Okay, right, so it didn't give me exactly the answer I need. Probably it doesn't mention on this report anyway, but still you can see how it answered the questions, and it always shows the exact places that when this answer came from. This is really good, really good. I quite like it. So let's ask the second question. I just want to know what's the top key findings from this whole year report for internal employee. That's who I am, right? I just already wrote this question. Let me paste it here. Imagine you are an employee works at Xero and you want to know the key info from this report so you can know what the company has been done last year. And please list out 10 top points from the whole report. Let's see what's the result will be. Who told me that as a AI language model, I don't have the personal briefs or emotions. However, do showed me here are a few things relevant to internal employees. For example, first, people and culture, customers, partners, and ecosystems. Okay, that's good. And it covers financial highlights, gross margin percentage. Okay, and Xero's ecosystem has grown. Okay, that's good. That's some solid summaries that I can take a look and see. Okay, those are the highlights. But for example, here, the organization announced in March included difficult decision to reduce 700 to 800 roles. Okay, so that's quite a good balance of different perspectives. So yeah, now I just want to take a step further because I'm a product designer at Xero. I just want to get some info for my role. Like imagine I am a product designer working at Xero. So let's see if there are any relevant insights to my job so that I can take a look. So again, it told me, so we can call it as a disclaimer. But then it told me a few things. First, Zero's objective is to enable customers to make informed decisions through real-time across the two information. That's quite good. I'm a little bit impressed. Let's see what the others. Zero continues to engage with its customers and partners to help drive further awareness and adoption of digital technologies. Okay, investing in tech platform provide the opportunity to deliver more innovation faster in more places around the world. Okay, it's a little bit on high level. Let's see, is there anything interesting? Okay, this one is interesting. Zero's investing in growing the AI capabilities across the product and help customers make better decisions using AI-powered insights. Okay, this could be interesting. I might have some internal opportunities to use in the company I'm working with. Right. Launch the instant bank pay feature to help customers get paid faster. Okay. And this one, Zero Payroll helps small business manage compliance because this is part of my divisions. It used to be, I used to be work close to this part. So that's really good. I see it as one of the insights here. And last part, Zero is investing in product design and development to deliver ongoing value for customers and unlock long-term efficiency, scalability, productivity, and speed to market improvements. Okay, so those are the things as an example. And previously, I just asked five questions relevant to this report, and I got those answers. And as a wrap up, I think first, I'm really happy that all those answers back with quotes and with specific pages that I can check for details, and which means that there's no hallucination, which is quite common for any AI model, right? And also the scope is it's just narrowed in this document, so there's not other external link, so which I think on this scenario is good. So I just want to learn things around this document. And also, I quite like this format. Like, I can ask questions and it's a proactive learning. And I can got the information I really relevant to what I'm going to work. So, and also just about those problems that I'm going to solve. So that's great. But I do have some questions. So first, if I'm using this tool, what the data privacy would be solved? For example, how do I know if sensitive data won't be leaked if I upload internal document to this website? And that could be a big issue. And it could be two things. First, for commercial reason, if I update any business sensitive document, that could be damage the company or the project. And second, if I update anything relevant to customers' privacy, that could be a legal issue, right? And from this example, you see, I uploaded a public document, and I will never do a sensitive document at this stage. So this is one thing I want to get answered. The second is that if I want to analyze some document with some images, and also like it's not as available as a PDF file or a Google Doc, is that possible that I can use OCR feature to scan all the text and analyze it? And I do see, I have the chat with people worked at ChatDoc, and they told me that it will be available soon. So I'm just keen to see how it's going to be. And also, I'm really happy that this feature is not as a first layer of using AI, like using ChatGPT to analyze things. So if we're doing that, that could be like ChatGPT could be the first layer. But now this product is built on ChatGPT's layer, which means that it could be more focused on the scenario, which at this scenario is the document I want to analyze. So that's really, really helpful. And as a tool of using AI to solve a real problem, so I'm keen to see there will be more relevant similar tools in the future, in the not so far future, that we can start to use to improve our productivity. Right, cool. I hope you like this video and like those examples. And let me know if you have any comments. I'll see you in the next one. Ciao.